C. Homo sapiens, supposedly 100 to 200,000 years old. D. Neanderthal, 50 to 100,000 years old. E. Homo sapien variety Neanderthaliensis, about 50,000 years old. And finally, F is modern Homo sapien. But let's just think about B for a second. B. Pithecanthropus erectus. What does that really mean? Well, for those that are Christians, when you study the Bible, you study about the life of the Theanthropos. Now, who is the Theanthropos? The Theanthropos is Jesus Christ. Theos means God. Anthropos is simply the old word for man, as in anthropology is the study of man. So the Theanthropos is the one who is 100% God and 100% man. That's Jesus Christ. But let's think about who is the Pithecanthropus erectus. Well, Pitha, ape, Anthropus, man, erectus, walking upright. And so this is the ape man who walks upright. Now that scientific name of Pithecanthropus erectus may not be familiar to you, but might. But maybe you're more familiar with it by its common name. Maybe in the textbooks that you were brought up with, they called it Java man. Let's just take a look at Java man for a moment, okay? Now, Java man, which was originally called Pithecanthropus erectus, meaning the ape man who walks upright, is now called Homo erectus, or man who walks upright. It was made from a few teeth and a skull cap found in 1891 along the banks of the Solo River in Java, Indonesia. Now, this was done by the Dutch anatomist, Dr. Eugene Dubois. He was a student of Dr. Ernst Haeckel, the German evolutionist, who was a disciple of Charles Darwin. Now, Dubois so believed in evolution that he had gone to Java, Indonesia to look for missing links between man and ape. Now, he arrived in December of 1887. His archaeological team consisted of two Dutch engineers, some prison labor convicts and so forth, two Dutch army corporals. Now, when he found these bone fragments, he sent a telegraph back to his mentor, Dr. Ernst Haeckel, announcing that he had found the bones. I'd like to show you a quotation from the telegram that, in fact, was sent back by Dr. Haeckel to Dr. Dubois. He said this, and I quote, "From the inventor of Pithecanthropus to his happy discoverer." You see, Dr. Haeckel had already made up the name. Dubois just went out to see if he could find the physical evidence to match up with it. But let's take a little look further at Java man. Now, Dubois actually took the skull cap of a giant gibbon, three human teeth, a human thigh bone that was actually found 1 year later in 1891, and it was 50 feet away from the other remnants. He put these together. He informed the world that he had found the missing link between apes and humans. But he had also found two totally normal human skulls in the same area in 1890. Now, what I'm talking about is recorded in a book available through our website called Bones of Contention by Marvin Lubino. But what had this man done? He had actually taken material from humans, apes, mixed them together, claimed that he had found an ape man, a prehuman, a subhuman, that had lived at some time in the past in Indonesia. Well, let's go back to this chart for just a moment. Now, let's think. A, here, is a dead southern ape. It's a dead chimpanzee. B, never existed. Now, C is Homo sapien. The last time I looked, that's us. D is Neanderthal, which is us. E is Homo sapien variety Neanderthaliensis, which is us. And F is modern Homo sapien, which is most assuredly us. So let's think for a second. We have one dead southern ape, something that never existed, and four human beings. How are we doing? Well, let's go on and take a look at some skulls. Now, I hope that I will not offend you by showing you pictures of skulls. I find this scary, but what I don't find scary is the skull. What I find scary is, if you'll notice down here in the lower left-hand corner, this comes from the Los Angeles, California Unified School District. This comes from a series that was used to teach children in elementary school that humans evolved from apes. Now, I'm just going to show you a couple of the series, but there was a whole series showing how supposedly chimpanzees, apes, had in fact evolved into humans. Now, this photograph, and this particular one, this is Peking man, Sinanthropus pekinensis. Well, I wonder if anybody here is concerned, at all about me showing you this photograph of the skull of a Peking man. Because if you're not, you should be. Let's take a little look at the story of Peking man, because you see, this photograph is not the photograph of the skull of Peking man. This is the photograph of the model of the skull of Peking man. Now, Peking man, it's found by Davidson Black. What did he do? He went to China between World War I and World War II. He went to what was then Peking, the capital now of Beijing. He went out into the countryside near the capital, and he set up a camp, and he found some pieces of skulls and so forth between 1921, and although he died in 1934, the work was continued to 1937. The work was only stopped when the Japanese invaded China. However, what's the story of these bones? Well, in 1937, when Japan invaded China, fellow evolutionists said, oh, these bones are too precious to allow them to stay in China. You must allow them to be shipped out of China for safekeeping during World War II. So, in 1941, the fragments were packaged up, shipped out of China, and promptly lost. They have never been seen again. That photograph was simply the model of the skull of Peking man. It was not the photograph of the skull of Peking man. Now, after World War II was over, again, evolutionary-believing anthropologists went back to the same location in China. And what happened? Well, they found out that Peking man never existed. What actually happened was that, basically an old farming village had been found. And there had been a mixture of ape and human remains put together, but the fact of the matter is, Peking man never existed. In today's literature, he's now referred to as Homo erectus, just as, again, Pithecanthropus erectus is now Homo erectus. It's just kind of a catch-all. Here's another skull. This skull is of a Neanderthal. It has a French name because it's a Neanderthal that was found in France, even though they were first found in Germany. And, you know, when you think of Neanderthals, this is what most people think of when they think about cave man. And I might add, cave woman. And I think they'd agree, if there are no cave women, there are going to be no cave men. But let's think about this term, cave man, in the first place, or cave woman. What does that word really mean? Well, it means a man or a woman who lives in a cave. Does it mean a ape becoming a man living in a cave? Does it mean it's a part man, part ape living in a cave? No, it means a man or a woman living in a cave. Now, one of the things that people ask me most often about these things is, are cavemen biblical? Remember, first response is, of course, cavemen and cave